someone, witness to someone, young fellow. Even see people in the church that says, I'm going to come preaching. I said, man, you done made your commitment to Christ yet? Yeah. Are you saved? I'm going to come preaching. But watch this. I'm going to do it when I get through doing this. When I get through that, when I get through this, I'm going to do it again. What they're saying, Sister Kathy, I'm going to do it when I develop. The title to the text today, and I want you to hear the title before we get into the word. God is not waiting for you to develop. God is waiting to develop you. God is not waiting, young people in the back, for you to develop. But God is waiting to develop you. Amen. St. John, let's begin. You can stand for this, and then we're going to get into St. John, first chapter 11 through 13. Verses 11 through 13. St. John, first chapter. And 11 through 13. And it begins reading. And he came unto his own, and his own received him not. We went to the conjunction today. Y'all know that? We were looking at T.J. Saturday morning. Conjunction. What's your function? Y'all gonna come on up in here. You know that, right? What? I don't know what they were looking at on Saturday morning now, but that's what we were looking at. Ain't that right? We were sitting there, get with it, T.J. I know y'all were thinking, y'all were saying that thing. I love it. That's that conjunction again, y'all. Let's look at this. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor of the will of flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. He came to his own received him not. But to them who did receive him, gave him power. You may be seated. Give me about 15 to 20 minutes, man. Jesus is not waiting for you to develop, but he's waiting to develop you. First thing I need you to understand is about this power. There's two kinds of power, young fellow, in the Word of God. One power that young fellow always talks about is dunamis, the Greek word dunamis, which means might, strength, explosion. We get our word dynamite from that. That's what young fellow here always talks about. He talks about dunamis. But this power right here is a Greek word called exousia. Exousia, and it's just like it sounds. Those of you who want to look it up, it is E-X-O-S-I-A, exousia. It's just like it sounds, which means basically the right, the authority to do something, okay? So this power that he gives us here is not necessarily that explosive power. Now, I'm going to go somewhere with you. I want y'all to stay with me. He gives us permission. Now, let me back this thing up right here. I'm going to use Coach. I'm going to use Bro Robert. I'm going to use myself. Now, if you were to see Coach, Bro Robert, and myself walking in the hall while class was in, first thing that's gonna happen, Swood and Sister Kathy, if you were a teacher, first thing you gonna wanna know, I want to see y'all permission stuff right now. See, when you know, y'all know when you have a permission slip, if you in the hall while class was on? Yes. Now, if they were to see Coach and Bert Robert, I may get away. I don't know what I'm saying. I might have got away. But if I'm with Robert, and Coach, they're going to throw us up this wall. Let me see y'all permission slip. What y'all doing out here in the hall? Let me see. But I'm going to get us some pencil. I'm going to get my teacher some pencil. She gave you a permission slip, you would be in the hall. But if you didn't have a permission slip, you should have been class. Now, I probably thought, all right, I have to do a coach with her brother. I probably could have got by. Even if I was supposed to be in the hall, I probably could have got by. But back in there with them two. And I throw them against the wall, I want to see my permission slip. Watch this, y'all. Stay with me. Stay with me. What he is saying here, this power that he talks about, or exousia, means that he has given you permission to be a part of the family. So anytime, now while y'all, I'm trying to stay with you. So anytime, Robert Cardell, that if I'm going along doing what I'm supposed to be doing, because see, the devil comes in, he don't always come in when you do what you're not supposed to be doing. Now, I want y'all to know, I had my permission slip. I was going down the hall, get my teacher some pencils. She sent me to the supply office to get some pencils. But because I looked like I wasn't doing what I was supposed to do, they didn't even try to come in. But if I'm doing what I'm supposed to do,
I don't want to know too much.
And drum would go left, watch this. He would go left just like this. He would go left with exorcism. He would go left with permission. Okay? And he would ask him one question. He said, how you gonna do this?
Some of y'all said,
I'm gonna come when I quit smoking. The devil ain't gonna let you quit. I'm gonna come when I quit drinking. The devil ain't gonna let you quit. Most of the people that will tell you they were in the church when God helped them develop that habit to quit. Come as you are. Amen. I may be able to see your habit, but I guarantee you, everybody wants to know something. And if they think they're not wanting to know something, they need to come up here and then catch that lying spirit out and stop it from lying. Somebody say amen. St. John. I'm moving up. I'm moving up. St. John 17, 1 through 4. These words spake Jesus and lifted up his eyes to heaven and said, Father, the hour is come. Glorify thy Son, that thy Son also may glorify thee. As thou hast given him what? As that word again, over all flesh, that he should give eternal life to as many as thou hast given him. Stay right there. God has the power over your flesh. God gives you eternal life. God is the one who draws you into the saving grace of Jesus Christ. You cannot do it on your own. God actually draws you to the saving grace. Matter of fact, let me backtrack. I'm sorry to carry you all over the map, Sister Brandon, but we got to this point in. Sister Brandon, go back to verse 13 in John, St. John, 1 John. I got to do something. I'm going to get myself in a little bit. There it is. Now listen, look at this, you all. These are all the ones that try to work out stuff before you come and get saved. He says, which were born not of blood, nor of the will of flesh. You can't get it right. Watch this. Nor of the will of man. But who did it? And who gonna do it? If we would just come as we are in our broken state and let God develop us and stop trying to develop ourselves, because you cannot do it in the will of flesh. You cannot do it in flesh. You cannot do it. But what you can do, it says, all to him I freely give. I surrender all to you. Matter of fact, until you surrender to God, you're not faithful anyway. You still trying to do it. But when you surrender to him and say, God, I cast my cares on you. All of them. Go back to the next text now, Brandon. These words, go to verse 3. And this is life eternal, that they might know thee, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom thou hast sent. I have glorified thee on earth. I have finished the work which thou gavest me to do. Stay right there. When Jesus was on the cross, he said, it is finished. It is the finished work, Ms. Rita, that makes the difference. Now, I can't sew, but I'm going to tell y'all that those of you who can sew, this makes sense to you. D.A. Shepherd, when a button falls off my shirt, and I don't know it till I get ready, I put the shirt on, I'm getting ready to come to church, and then I notice the button is off. So then Tony has to sew the button on with me in the shirt. Now watch this. She sews, I watch her sew, and y'all stay with me now. When she is finished. Stay with me on this. I want y'all to stay with me. If you're with RJ, say you're with me. Watch this, y'all. When she gets finished sewing the buttonhole, Karen, she carries it in a knot, okay? Pulls it. And then stay with me. When she does that, there's a little string or a little hem that's left. That means her work is. Can I help y'all? The woman with the issue of blood touched the. She touched the finish. Y'all didn't get that. Y'all missed that. What she touched was Jesus' finished. She knew her healing was already there. All I need to do is touch the finish. Your salvation is already there. All you need to do is touch the finish. Your deliverance is already there. All you need to do is touch the finish. Touch the finish. Somebody here may need to touch the finish. Word. Ain't God all right with me? The finish. Jesus said, I have, look at the last one. I want to put it at the end. He says, I have, I want everybody to say that. I have the
word.
I have the
word.
I have
the
word. Jesus had
finished.
The
word.
Jesus had
finished.
The
word.
All you got to do is accept. He's done. As a matter of fact, Kevin, all you can do, the only thing you can do for him not to save you is to deny. Unless you deny, you don't save. Because he's done everything. One more, I'm closing out. 19, go to the last one. I'm closing out here. She's fabulous. I want y'all to look at this. I mentioned this earlier. Then said Pilate unto him, and watch this. Very soft. This is for all you who are facing maybe a court case or something where you're going to be. Question. God gave me this morning in a powerful way. Or maybe you're facing something where your word is their word. Maybe it's on the job, where it was at. It was in the courts, maybe. I don't know where it's at. God knows. I'm not sure what happened to you. Jesus said to Pilate, Terrell, he said, I'm actually going through this. He says, I'm going through this because God allowed it. Oh my God. When we get right there, we'd be somewhere, y'all. Pop went through that because what? Sister Brown went through that because what? Pastor T went through it because what? Lord told me, don't you open your mouth, because if you open your mouth, you're going to blow it. And I would have blown it, Karen. I would have blown it. God would have told him, you know. Look at this, y'all. I want to show you something. Mother Agnes, we would have blown it. You know it. Y'all look at this. Then said, power unto him in Jesus. Speak of not unto me, you won't say nothing. Knowest thou not that I have the power to crucify thee and the power to release thee? Look at the next verse. Yeah. Jesus answered, thou couldst not have no power at all against me except it was given thee from above. If God didn't allow me to go through this, you wouldn't even, you better please. Then he said, therefore, he that delivered me unto thee had the greater sin than what's there. That's going to make them change their mind. Jesus said, you ain't got no power against me. He said, but whatever fool is crazy enough to execute judgment on me, that's the one that's saying. Now, which one of y'all would have that blood on your hand for the innocent man? Which one of y'all would have, listen, did you ever heard they'll start backing up here? Look, power start backing up. And then the next verse said, power tried to get out of it. Power start backing up. Now, watch this. Look at the next verse. And from this fall, power sought to release him. Power said, listen, can I get out of here? Listen, I don't want the blood on my arm. You see what I'm saying? The preacher. This deacon, this choir member, this layperson, this minister of music, this woman of God. I hold that blood over, let me back up out of it. Let me see what I got. Let me get out of it. This choir member, this faithful tiger. I don't want it on my head. I don't want to take it. No, let me back up. I don't want it, because then my arm too shot to talk to God. You know that, right? Sister Rita, they are too short. The box with God. And from this forth power sought to release him. But the Jews cried out. You got to watch the crowd of people. Because they come in one Friday and say, Hosanna. And the next Friday they say, saying, if thou will let this man go, thou art no friend of Caesar's. Whosoever maketh himself a king, speaking against Caesar. God is not waiting for you to develop. God is simply waiting for you to come so he can develop you. God is waiting for you to give up all that you think you can do for the simple truth that you can't do nothing. And I need God to go my own. And if you're here today and you need God to go your own, he's not waiting for you to develop. He's not waiting for you to get it all right. He's not waiting for you to have it just like it's supposed to be. Because you'll never get to that point. He's waiting for you to humble yourself under the mighty hand of God and come down here and say, I need thee. Oh, how I need thee. Every hour, I need thee. Would you come? The doors of the church are open.